brought to you by
Eaton Detroit Spring, proudly made in the USA.
Classic Car or Muscle Car, we want to show you how to restore your automobile and save yourself some money in the process. Sometimes we consult the pros, sometimes we mess up. But just remember, it's never a problem, it's always a project.
Right now on Autorestomod, Jeff and Dustin go for a ride Andy Griffith style, then Jeff fixes a brake pedal that is just too high.
Honey, what are you doing out there?
Waiting on the next Super Blowout 3-day only mega sale.
You don't need a sale. You need NPD.
NPD's everyday prices are competitive with most sales, and orders arrive fast from our four strategically located superstores. National Parts Depot has quality parts for Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, GTO, Firebird, Ford, and Chevy truck. For your free catalog, go online or call toll-free.
Working beats waiting.
So, Jeff, what are we doing this week?
Well, this week, Dustin, we're going to be going in and doing a pedal adjustment because, quite frankly, when I put the Maverick Master Cylinder in my 69 wagon, I used the Maverick actuator rod, and you know what? When I go to brake,
looks like you're a dog taking a pee.
Wow, that's an analogy I wouldn't have gone with, but okay, yes, I have to lift my leg up far too much in order to get this thing to brake correctly because the pedal is now too high, something you can run into when you're going to a different Master Cylinder on a car.
All right.
So, this week we're going to be doing that.
Why do I feel like I'm in an Andy Griffith episode?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
This guy.
Right, gonna break.
You want a race?
Sure. Ready?
3, 2, 1,
go. Now, what we've got here is a pedal that is far too high. Sometimes this will happen when you go with aftermarket brake assemblies, and you'll need to go in and do something about that. And what you can do about it is the part I'm going to show you in just a second, but what I wanted to give you is the correct depth measurement from the accelerator pedal to the top of the brake pedal for most Ford products. Now, on this, we took a measurement off of our late model 2005 Crown Vic police car so that we can know that we're about right on that. And we've done a couple of other cars as well. So we know that the measurement needs to be right at 2 inches from the top of our accelerator pedal to the top of our brake pedal. And what you want to do, if you want to check yours, is to put a piece of wood, like we've used our ruler here, and set it on the face of the accelerator pedal, and then measure the distance. We're probably at 5.5 inches off the top of the accelerator pedal to the top of the brake pedal. That's way too tall. And I found it being a case where I've had a couple of times where I've almost gotten into an accident because my brake pedal is not where I anticipate it to be. Now, the nice thing is, what I'm going to show you next is the part that Scott Drake offers to allow you to make this fully adjustable so you can set this brake pedal right exactly where you want it. Okay, so what we're going to talk about this week is master cylinders in relation to the pedal rod assembly that we have here. Now, the pedal rod that was in there was even a little higher than I like because the original owner did. He actually went in and put a Maverick Master Cylinder in his Fairlane with the front disc brakes that he added from the Granada. This is a fairly popular upgrade, but a lot of guys don't realize why this is a good idea. Now, what this Master Cylinder has that you don't usually get is a smaller bore diameter. The smaller the bore diameter, the less pedal effort you're going to have when going in and doing your braking. So if you're going to do a disc brake conversion, this kind of a master cylinder, which is, this is our old one, we've pulled it out already and created the problem we have with the pedal rod assembly, but your master cylinder, if it is a 7/8 or a 15/16, is going to give you better pedal effort on disc brakes than you would get with a larger bore diameter, say a 1-inch bore. Now, the reason we created a problem was is we actually used the Maverick actuator rod that goes with this master cylinder when you get it from wherever you buy it. We got ours from Rock Auto, but whenever you buy this assembly, the pedal rod that comes in it most of the time is too long for the Fairlane or even the Mustang. Now, one of the things you can do is you can use your original brake pedal assembly as long as it is a manual brake car. This rod from your Torino or your Mustang will go right into the Maverick Master Cylinder and lock in place as long as the C-clip that's on the end here is still on there. Okay? It's just as easy to go out and buy one of these if you're like me and don't have the original. Scott Drake offers this, and we got ours through the guys at Summit. Now, this is a fully adjustable rod that I've got here. You basically take the lock nut loose, and you can adjust this thing to wherever you want that pedal assembly to sit. So you can essentially go in and adjust this down to where you got right at a 2-inch pedal height, making it to where it feels more like a Ford of any shape or variety that you jump in and out of. Our goal on our cars around here is to always try to make these things easy for anybody to get in and drive, so I don't have to explain to someone getting into the car all the things that need to be done to make it run correctly. Something like this will give you a standard pedal height and you'll be good to go. Now what we're going to do is we're going to show you how to take it off the original one and put the new one in. All right, now if you're going to be doing one of these, you're going to need to go in and remove the master cylinder in order to take the pedal rod out of it. I've seen it where you don't do that, where guys yank on the pedal assembly, but I don't think that's a really good idea. It's better to pull it out and actually remove it with the method I'm going to show you. Now, we basically had to go in and take the pedal support assembly apart on the inside of the car. That meant removing the pin that we got from NPD, as well as the isolators and all, and the brake light switch from the rod assembly, and then also removing the rod assembly from the pedal on the car. So we're going to go in now, we're going to use what we've got here. Now these two are not necessary in order to do this, but I'm going to go ahead and use them anyway. These are basically just plugs that we're going to put on our master cylinder when we pull it out, so we don't get brake fluid all over the joint. You'll be using a 9/16 and a 7/16 on the master cylinder to remove your brake lines, and then you'll use a 9/16 typically to take the master cylinder off of the firewall. Leave your cap in place, leave your bail on. It's a good idea to go ahead and re-bleed them after you pull the master cylinder out, put it back in, because you're going to have air in the line from removing the master cylinder. So, I'm going to go ahead and get started on this and show you what we need to do. Now, the first thing I've done is I've gone in and already loosened these a little bit, but you're going to have to take these loose from here and pull those off. Now, I'm going to just leave them hang there and take the master cylinder away from the brake lines rather than trying to go in and pull the brake lines away from the master cylinder. It's going to make a little more sense here in a second. These brake lines have taken a set. In other words, I've set these up where they need to be. I really don't want to lose that setting if I can help it. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually take the brake master cylinder loose from the firewall. Now this one is kind of a bugger to get to on these cars, but it's all the way out. Now I can kind of pull that off a little bit and pull my master cylinder out. Now you'll note I left the original master cylinder arm that came with it on there. Actually, they come disassembled. So if you're going to do the pedal assembly and the brake master cylinder at the same time, I would recommend going in and not putting this rod assembly on there. I would go ahead and just put the adjustable rod on there so you've got room to play, so to speak. Now you'll want plugs in here when you're doing this because you're going to be putting a lot of pressure on this rod down in order to remove it. So best idea is to plug these up, because if you don't, you may be squirting brake fluid all over the floor. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my big hammer and my pick and get this rod assembly out of the new master cylinder. We've taken it out of the old one, worked okay, so that means probably this time it'll fight all the way. What you want to do is mount it in a vise, and I've used two pieces of wood right now to hold the master cylinder in place. I could have just put it in there raw and let the cleats hold onto it, but I want to try and not mark up my master cylinder so I don't have to do any repaint work on it. So what you want to do is you want to bang this out with your hammer, getting as close down by the push rod as you can get. Just a little more force. That's all it needed. Yeah, I got to put the other one in. All right, this points out how a little bit can make a lot of difference. You'll note that there really is a ton of length difference between the two different push rods. This one is a little shorter, and this may be an original Torino push rod. I don't recall the brakes having that big a difference on the original master cylinder that was on here that started weeping on us. So I went ahead and pulled these so you could see this. Now what we're going to probably do to start off with our new adjustable is to set it up to the length that was originally in the car and then pull that out if we want to get it closer down by the accelerator pedal. But this will just show you how just a very small amount can make a huge difference. This could mean 4 inches at the actual brake pedal because you're down at the end of a fulcrum. So in other words, if it's up here, let's say this is our brake pedal arm right here. If it's this length and you only have a half inch here, way down at the end of the pedal down here, you're going to be looking at it being more like 3, 4, or 5 inches in depth. So very little change here can make a huge difference down at this end. So I'm going to make sure I've got all the junk out of the inside of my new master cylinder where we took that pin out so we don't have any residue of the pin in there, because it had this style of clip in position. So I want to make sure that I've got my pin in there, all of this stuff out of the inside of the master cylinder before we put the new one in. Now basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a pick to go down inside the piston area here to make sure that we get all of the pieces out of it. And I've already pulled up a couple of small pieces. Here's one of them. Now if this stuff remains down inside that bore, it can stop it from hitting the bottom where it needs to be. So you want to make sure you get all that out of there. Basically, you just want to take your pick and a little flashlight and run down in there and grab up all the stuff that may be in there. Okay, so I set this up to our original Torino length. We know that that is from the very end piece here all the way to the tip of the cap, about 6 3/8 of an inch. And I say about because it's kind of an ishy if. Now, the nice thing is once we get this in the car, we'll be able to actually spin this to set our depth and get it where we want it to be. We may want to take some of that out of it. It may have originally been a little bit high compared to what other Ford stuff is. So we're going to take this, stick this in here after we put our dust boot on, and then put this in and then get it in the car and see what we got. Okay, now what we're going to do is we've already gone in and put the brake light on the car. Now we had to go in and modify our arm just a little bit to get the brake lights to not deploy. Now a good idea is to go ahead and rough mount this in, put your brake light switch on, put everything in position, and check your brake lights. If your brake lights are running, you need to take the arm and knock just a little bit off of it. We probably had to take a little less than 1/16 off the end of that arm so the brake lights wouldn't deploy all the time. We did that, everything looks great now, so we're gonna go in now and give you a couple little tips on doing your brake setups. You wanna save yourself some frustration and some grief when you're putting all those back together. Leave your master cylinder loose on the firewall when you're going in and setting and tightening up your brake lines. Always with your brake lines, hand tighten them first if you can, and then put a wrench to them, because if you don't do that, you can end up cross-threading these things. Now we got a 9/16. And you always want to use a line wrench on these if you've got them in your kit, because it's just a lot better for the nuts on here if they're tightened with a line wrench. So do that and tighten up your master cylinder on the firewall so you'll get your final position. And after that, you can go underneath the dash panel and finish everything up. All right, this is already a ton better. We're at about 3 inches, but I'll show you. We'll do another measure like we did before. Taking our yardstick, sticking it in here. And our measure's at about 3 inches compared to what we had before, which was over 5. I'm pretty happy with that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to knock that tension nut loose up underneath the dash panel and go in and start adjusting the pedal down. It won't take a lot, probably maybe a half turn or a full turn to get down to the 2-inch mark that we're looking for on this car. Well folks, that's our show for this week. Now one little piece of information I wanted to give you before we get out of here. The section that you saw at the beginning of the show was actually an exercise I set up for my crew on green screening. Not only are we a how-to show that shows you guys how to work on your cars, but we're also a show that has people learning how to produce video on board. We have folks anywhere from 10 years of age all the way up to guys in their 30s that come in and work with us and help us shoot so that they can learn the process of what we do around here on a weekly basis. We do have some steadies like Dustin Snellings, who's on board and here pretty much every week, and the rest of the guys kind of float in and out depending on what their schedules are. So anytime you see something on the show, just realize that it could be shot by someone anywhere from 10 years old all the way up to 30 with varying skill levels. And we like doing that. We love teaching. So that's the whole impetus behind what we do here. We teach you and we teach, well, them, because there's a guy behind the camera. So do us a favor and come back and watch us next week on Autorestomod. Have a great week, folks.